Welcome back to Let's Play Dragon Slayer, Legend of Heroes Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. Now, well, beginning in earnest, the finale, Dragonfire. So, on the home stretch here. Big Giles says, what's keeping you? Move it, or you'll miss my boat. Miss your boat. Malone says, when you're done over there, will you be the Bandit King? I don't think he ever wants to be the Bandit King. Bugsy says, watch yourself, Giles. It's deadly out there. Alright, so I'm just gonna talk to everybody, see if there's anything new here. Phaser says, little Giles, guess what? I've been promoted by the big boss himself. I'm the new Mason. I gotta fix that hole sometime. Girls have anything new to say? My rich friend still needs a mate. What about this Fraser? Make millions, boys. Thanks. I think. Oh, here's Isaac. I'm planning to design a balloon. That old kite was too unstable. A balloon will gain altitude rapidly. Daniel says, Big Giles is showing me all the tricks of the trade. Soon I'll be able to pick any lock in the world. The whole world? Cutter says, these guys act real hardcore, but they have hearts of gold. Marcus says, yes, sir, me. The easy life's for me. Still miss you, Marcus. So, his little stall is empty. Fortune teller. Was it always a fortune teller? Or there's a priest or something here. Good luck. I think you'll be needing lots of it. The same thing here. Warp quills and warp wing. Yeah, I don't need any of that stuff. This swine across from me started flapping his gums again. I think I may have to rearrange his face. Me and my mates are great thieves, but I think I'm the best. I can steal anything from anyone, anytime. I was taking a look at my money and make sure he didn't steal from me. Good to see you. I hear you're off the Jaggery Pit. It's bad news for you. It's full of filth and evil thugs. Did you buy any weapons or armor from Jimmy? I think you should. But remember one thing, his goods are weak against fire. Yeah, I wonder if that's gonna be a problem. This guy's a liar. I only hand out medicine in here. Wanna stay and rest? Hit the road, buddy. We don't need to rest, right? So that's why, yeah. That's why we're hitting the road. Alright, so let's... I just want to check in on Jalan. Couldn't remember the name. Oh, isn't that where we are? Duh. I mean Carcass. That was silly. Cucumber for 10. I don't know about that. I'm gonna sell... hope it's not a mistake. I'm gonna sell this gem rod. 97,500 gold. I'm gonna keep the gold card just in case. This is a fine spring day, is it not? You bagged the beast, didn't you? Because of your bravery, you can keep my gold card as a souvenir, like. Now, I'm tempted to sell it, but I think I might hold on to it just in case or might need it somewhere. Greetings, heroes. Bend your ears and you'll hear a tale. So This is one I read. Long, long ago, the Immortals fought a great war against the Darkest Horde. Nadja led the Horde forces to burn and purify the land with Dragonfire. The fire brought civilization to its knees, but the Seeker, feeling pity for the last humans, snatched them away. They found refuge in this land. The Seeker's powers protect us from chaos and keep Isrenasa in light. The Seeker aids followers of the true path with great powers. Giles says, same old song and dance, huh, Janice? Conquer the world. Sage says, I know powerful war spells. For the warriors who did in Gaia, spelled wrong again, I offer my magic. Flame 5. He doesn't have flame. I'll replace flame 4. It's done. Use it wisely, friend. Alright, shock 5. Yeah, replace shock with that. Some other people have flame as well. Yeah, replace that flame. And this flame. Now, does someone else have shock, though? Shock 4, now we have shock 5. Ice 5 for Logan. No. I hardly ever use these. Place ice 4. Waste 4. Someone has waste. I think. Your waste. There it was there. In Psycho. Okay, let's restart it because I dropped to Windows. Okay, Psycho I was doing. That really threw me off. I don't know why that happened. Return to Carcass and I'll be here. Prime Minister should be high and dry now. Thanks to you, my re-election is certain. Hold on one second, guys. Okay. Now I'm sneezing. What the hell is going on here? Is it nice to live in peace and harmony? There's no end to the amount of work I have to do. That's the complainer. I'm trashed. The archaeologist? He's out of here. Went to Acadia. I want to go see him in Acadia, actually. I'll go there next. No more work. Gotta like that. Take 5, dude. What a man. You slew Gaius and now we're on holiday. Sweet. Okay, that's it for this place. I'm just gonna save because we crashed the desktop like that. Yes, I guess we'll go to Acadia. Kids seem to be travelers. If you ever go by Carcass, say hello to storyteller Janice and her son, and you got in my way. Nothing up here anyway. Ach, my poor Colin. I'll miss his good stories. But he came back. Where is he? This is what they said. It's no problem now. We slew Gaius and cleared the tower. Well, I'll be. So now what do I have to talk about? Not me. Oops. Well, say he went back here, but he's not here. Well, we can rest here, but not try not to run into him. We can't rest in Cape Via. I see no reason to go back to Cape Via. Let's just go to straight to Port Moor. I think it's Port Moor. This is where I'm supposed to take the boat. The boot. Thomas has devoted his life to the Seeker. Wow, way cool, Father Dave says. Let me try, Father. Wow, way cool. Life's great, isn't it? Though my daughter ran off with some sailor. I don't have any savings, but we're getting married. We really ought to put our noses to the grindstone and get the Seeker's help. What you need now is a good long rest. Oh, I guess so. We're getting married in the morning. Ding dong, the bells are gonna chime. Yeah, I don't know. Hope you fare better than the other, Romeo and Juliet. They decided to get engaged. I'm jealous. We took money. Hopefully not a lot. I ain't bragging, but I stole a ton of money from Hans. Rocco says, I've been waiting to take you to Fort Wynd. I heard you're going to Jagri. Only exiled convicts are sent there. You'll have to bribe the gate guards or you won't get out of the fort. They're real strict. Hey, maybe you can pretend to be on Karatav's inspection team. Anyway, let's board. My mate Jack won't like us to be late on his release day. Well, I wanted to talk to a few more people, but... Okay, we're not... Okay, good. I don't know if there is anyone else to talk to. I'll talk to her. Big Giles told us that the country is free. Must be, because I can't see any more monsters. I'm sure those monsters are just waiting outside. Yeah, she's a scary monster, this one. Alright. I don't think there's anyone else to talk to. Alright, let's go. Jazzy sailing music. Ooh, sorry about that, guys. Hope you didn't hear all that static. Just turned my mic back on and that happened. This is a long ride. Never heard the song go this long. I think I'm gonna save right after this so we don't have to watch all this again in case something happens. It started over. I wonder if this is the most efficient way to go. It's like we're going around. Okay, Fort Wynd. Wow. Rocco says, have today's prisoners come through yet? The fort guard says, nah, not yet. Wait, here comes someone now. Shaq says, all right, it's Rocco. Been a while. Where have you been? We've been waiting forever. Sorry, Ace. The hike from Doomkeep takes time. Doomkeep, huh? Hey, guard, it's me, Jack. I'm going free today. Jack, huh? I didn't recognize you. Jack says, you must be new around the fort, eh? Any more lips, Sonny, and you'll be back on a chain gang. Rocco says, you're looking good, bro. Don't sweat it. Big Giles has it all fixed, plus a ship to get us out of here. Sounds good. What about you, Giles? What brings you to the Outlands? I'm looking for the Sword Blaze. Know anything about it? Never even heard of it. Why don't you ask your old pal Dale? He's up in Doomkeep. As for me, I think I'll just mosey on home. Got a bit of catching up to do. So see you around. So Doomkeep is not a dungeon? It sounds like one. Let's go, Rocco. Sure thing, Jacko. Later, guys. Good luck. Okay. Back in control. Slimebag says, what's the deal? No one but convicts go through here. Perhaps if you were to grease my palms with gold, I'd look the other way. Charles says, get a life. You're as bad as old Drax. Ethan says, whose side are you on anyway? I guess you could say that I go the highest bidder. Sonya says, you lowlife, draw your sword. Logan says, hold on, Sonya. We should feel sorry for him. How does 356,346 gold sound? Do you have the 356,34? No. Is that it? Gotta come up with something better. So you ain't going by unless you pay up. That's like half our... Is that half our gold? Hold on. Oops. 356. 356. 346. Yeah, I mean, we couldn't... It's rounded up. But, yeah, that's half our gold. That's crazy. I wonder if we come back with less gold, if the number will change. I mean, there is a place to, like, buy some stuff. Maybe they have weapons here. I haven't even looked around or anything. Here's a place where we can rest, I guess. Old Crone says, lately I've seen a small dragon flying through the night sky, wailing like a baby. It's looking for its parents. Is that right? That's right. The sooner it finds its parents, the better. Huh. Is that the dragon that was following us around? My days in the pit wilted my mind. My warp's useless. What brings you to this hole anyway? Logan says, we're searching for the Sword Blaze. I know nothing of it. Why don't you try the ruins beneath Doomkeep? So there's Doomkeep is like, I guess a keep or fort type place with the ruins like a dungeon underneath. McKinley, the trader, says, friends, how's the traveling going? I'm here to deal. My weapons are the best a gold can buy, and don't run out of warp wings. Take your time. Have a good look. Oh my god. Okay. We got battle suit for 300,000, jade shield for 200,000, and star blade for 300,000. I'm here to help anytime. Don't forget Fort Wynd. I thought I had plenty of money for everything. She can find another way out of here so we don't have to pay all that money. It seems to me that you're in need of something, right? That's right, we seek Sword Blaze. So he's spelling out Sword Blaze. The East. It's in the East. Child says, I hope for your sake that you're telling us the truth. Well, Fort Wynd is to the east. I'm looking at the map. Doomkeep is to the west, as is Jaggery Pit. Did I say east? Maybe it's west. Or north. Or the signs are very confusing. Give up while you still can. Oh, brother. I'd rather fight that guy than give him money. Alright, let's see. We can buy and sell. Oh my god, sorry. All I did was lean forward. I hope you guys are not hearing the static. It's kind of annoying. Alright, so I just saved. Starblade is 300,000. Battlesuit, 300,000. Jade Shield, 200,000. Let's see. If you buy two of these, okay. So his defense is 360. Wow. Same here. So these won't be vulnerable to the fire like the gem stuff is. So that's worth it, because we might run into fire stuff around here. Who knows? So you can get 150,000 from here. Still don't have enough for another gem mail. Battle suit. But we can buy a Jade Shield. Alright, 560. 600. Sell the gem plate. 600,000 gold. Now I wonder if this amount changes. So, you ain't going by unless you pay up. It's less. 61,346 gold sound. that works. I don't think I'm gonna need the gold card. I still don't have enough. That's cheap. Cheap to sell anyway. So I'm trying to manipulate this so I give this guy the least amount of money possible. Because now we have more money, but we still can't buy... And we can't get more money from anybody else to make up the 25,000. Hopefully we'll have to pay this guy every time we leave the town as well. Because then I gotta figure that into buying this equipment. Alright. Hold on. I'm buying. Now sell them. This is 52,500. So this makes that this guy will only take like 20,000 gold. Still hope you guys can't hear that. Sorry if you can. I'm not sure why. I'll have to check my connections after the episode. I'm gonna do it now. So Jade Shield. 600. $20,000. You're gonna fall for it, huh? What a laugh. The place is yours. Don't fall into Jagri Pit. Har har. If you find this sword blaze, you better let me see it. We'll do no such thing. Old Red says, ah, look, it's one of Korotov's pit inspection teams. Hey there, can you ask the Prime Minister to send us back home? Billy Bob says, we want out of here. Put in a good word for us, huh? Alright, we're broke, but we got new stuff. Alright, so Fort Wynd. Do we want to go to Doomkeep first? Then we go this way. Oh, wait. Oh, no, 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 no. That's not where we are. Okay. Never mind. We gotta go around all this. Can we go through here? Are we not supposed to be attacked by anything? Because we're not being attacked by anything. I think this is Doomkeep, actually. Oh, hello. Benjamin's Tough. Says, you're new in town, so I'll tell you how we do things. The most important thing is to be nice to the boss man. Then you gotta think about that slimy dog, Scott. The boundary is right here. Ain't that hilarious? Logan says, ha ha ha, sure is. The rest of the party gives Logan a blank stare. Ethan says, was it that funny, Prince? Giles says, don't waste your breath on him. Benjamin's Tough says, you'll catch on real quick. Leastways, I hope so. Anyways, this is the boundary. Left is Benjamin's, right is Scott's. That boundary? Should we not be crossing that yet or something? Father Jones says, good to see some new faces. Let me fill you in. Below Doomkeep are ancient ruins from the distant past. These beautiful candle stands are made from steel found down there. As for me, my work is to spread the Seeker's wisdom to the inmates. Keep the Jaggery Pit workers in line. Stop by for tea. Okay. Scott's Ruffian says, since you're new on the block, you'll have to learn the ropes. And the ropes is this. Don't mess with Uncle Scotty. Big Ben is one mean hombre, too. Don't get on their bad side, or else. This is Scott? Well, they look like they're all clowns or something. Logan says, excuse me, do you know of Sword Blaze? Scott's Ruffian doesn't say anything. What's wrong? Giles says, you're deaf or something? Sonya says, looks as if we're being ignored. Ethan says, it's the way you ask. Leave it to me. Excuse me, but would you happen to know the whereabouts of Sword Blaze? Scott's Ruffian says, shut up! What's all the racket? The ruffian tenses up in a rage and clenches his fists. Logan says, thanks, Ethan. Way to go. The same thing. Okay. Alrighty then. Empty. I don't want to run into you. Alright. I still don't want to run into you. Dale says, Giles, is it really you? It's me, Dale. Hey, guy. I haven't seen you since we blew that hole in Big Giles' wall. Jack told me you'd be here. Jack? He left for Fort Wynd this morning. But how'd you get here? Last I heard, you were doing time for pickpocketing. Giles says, who? Me? What a joke. You must have been talking to liars. But anyway, you ever hear of the Sword Blaze? Sounds real important. No, I never heard of it. The Sword Blaze, huh? I'll keep my ears open and give you any news I hear. Miner says, Jack and Boris went free today. Boris just left. Professor Smith says, hey, I've seen your faces somewhere before. I'm the professor. I got caught stealing just to get in here and explore the ancient ruins for artifacts. Logan says, did you say explore? Then maybe you know the Sword Blaze? I'm not sure. Ah, yes. Now I remember. That is one amazing piece of work, let me tell you. Giles says, I say this guy's bluffing us. Me too, Sonya says. He looks nervous and sweaty. Yeah, yeah. Sword Blaze. That's a ticket. Okay. Scott says, "You better watch your eyes, boy, because I'll gouge him out." Benjamin says, "Spineless cur, it's just like you to fight like a woman." Benjamin says, "What a wimp, eh? Are you all new crew members or what?" Logan says, "No, we're looking for the sword blaze." "We don't need your scum around here. You're probably spies for that swine Scott. Now go on, get." "Tell Scott he ain't getting any of my gold from the ruins." Benjamin's tough says, "Ain't Benjamin the greatest? He's twice as strong as Scotty, and Scotty always made me give him half my wages. What a slime ball, huh?" See, he ran off here. Scott, "Did that weakling called Benjamin send you over? Tell him I'll never forgive him." Okay. Well, we got not exactly a friendly rivalry going on here. Just making sure we didn't miss anything. Oh, there's a stairs down over here. Benjamin's guard says, "Hold it! No one enters the ruins without Ben's permission." Oh, I guess we gotta get Ben's permission. Oh. Well, he's not talking. I wonder if anyone else would help. See Benny quick. He needs to replace Boris. Okay. I just was talking to him. Oh. Okay. Still not talking to me. Dale says, "Nothing yet, Giles, buddy. Just hang in there." Well, maybe we have to go to Jaggery Pit first. Can't get around him. Alright. I guess we'll try Jaggery Pit next episode. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.